Hello, this is Travis Sabin with Adobe Analytics Product Management, and today I'm going to be walking you through the landing page for Analysis Workspace. So in Adobe Analytics, when you log in, this is the experience that you will see. We have all of your Analysis Workspace projects listed here. We have this divided in a couple of ways. We have this menu with three tabs on the side. We have a project menu, a reports tab, and a learning tab. On the project tab, you can see we have this table with a list of all your projects and some metadata associated with it. The reports tab is a collection of pre-built reports, similar to reports that previously existed in reports and analytics or some of our Adobe templates, and those can all be accessed here. And then the learning tab provides a set of Adobe-provided content to help users get started and learn some of the fundamentals of Adobe Analytics. If you are in need of additional real estate to view something like on this table here, you can click on this menu here, and that will collapse the three tabs on the side, giving you a little bit more space for your table here. Also here on the screen, you can see we've got this hero banner kind of across the middle. This is a great place to get started on something quickly. So if you want to just start analyzing something right away with a single click, you click that open and you get a blank project to get started. So you can do a blank project or mobile scorecard. If you want to dive into some learning right away, we have a training tutorial right here. If you click that, it will open up the training tutorial that we have to help you learn a little bit about the fundamentals of Analysis Workspace. Or if you're interested in reading about the latest release notes, you click on this, it'll take you to a separate tab with the latest release notes that we have. So if the hero banner isn't something you care too much for, then you can collapse it again to have additional real estate for the table. I love the single click to open the blank project, so I always like having this open. So next, up here in the corner, if you didn't want to click the single click here in the banner, you can click on Create Project. This will bring up our project modal. You can again click on blank project or blank scorecard, but we also have in here any company provided templates that any admins have set up for your organization. They can be found here in this modal. All the Adobe provided templates, as previously mentioned, are located now in the Reports tab with all of our other pre-built content. A great new feature for the landing page is the option to organize your projects into folders. So you can create a new folder using this button here. You give it a folder name, a tag if you want, demo folder. And now I've got a new demo folder here listed on my list. There are two types of folders. There is a company folder that everybody has. You'll see that it's got this little person next to it. It is shared with every single user across your organization. So this is created instantly and automatically for everyone. You can't delete it. You can't get rid of it. It is here for everybody. This is a place for admins to organize projects that they would like to share out with their entire organization. So if you have something for the marketing team, you could open up the company folder, create a marketing subfolder, and put all your marketing projects in here for the marketing team to find. Everyone will have access to it, so non-marketers could technically open this up and look at that content. So there's no restrictions on who can view what within the company folder. Everybody can see everything, but you can, through naming and organization, create those folders however you like. All other folders that you might create here are your personal folders. They are not shareable. They're not anything that you can do to create or impact folders for other people. It is a personal folder organization. So you can take all your projects that you have on your landing page here and you can organize them however you like. You can keep them unorganized if you want, or you can put them inside folders. So you have that option. And then here on the screen right now, well, this is a mixture of your folders and projects at this root level. If you wanted to only see a list of all of your projects outside of their folders, you can change the view to all projects. And this will give you basically a flat list of every single project. This is basically what we used to have in the landing page, is a running list of your projects here outside of their folders and unorganized. But the folder view is the default view with the company folder and any personal folders that you might have. So to move something into a folder, you simply click it, or you could multi-select, and then here on the little blue banner, you click on the move to, you select, if I want to move into my demo folder, I do that. And now within the demo folder, you can see here on the type we have folder, and it shows the number of contents. Now it has two listed next to it. I open it up, and here are the two projects I just moved in there. So that's a really brief overview of folders. There's a separate video for a deeper dive of folders if you're interested in learning more about some of the ins and outs of folders. So now let's talk a little bit about the table here. There's a couple of great things that make this table different from our previous table on the landing page. First of all, obviously, is just the combination of things that you can see here. We have folders and projects, and you'll notice that some of these are pinned. So if there are certain things that you always want to see, whether it be a project or a folder, you can pin them simply by clicking on this ellipses and clicking pin. You can also check the box and pin it there, and then you can automatically pin it to that list. If you want to unpin something, you simply click the little push pin and it will unpin it. You can also move and reorder these pinned projects and folders through the ellipses menu. There's an option to move them up or down if you want to put them in a different order of some kind. Pinned content will stay here at the top of your list. And then you have other options here for sorting and finding what you're looking for. So we have introduced this star for any projects that you have favorited. They will show up here with this star next to them. You can sort by favorites if you want, so you can see all your favorited stuff at the top. This is another way to just define exactly what you're looking for. We've added some additional column types here. The one that I like the most is last open. We've always had last modified, but last open is really, really valuable to know what projects you've been in recently. So we have a new column here to capture exactly which ones you've been looking at personally, so you can sort by that to see which projects you've been in the most recently. We've also added a scheduled column here. So now you can see really quickly which of your projects are currently scheduled, and any that are scheduled, like for example, this one, my mobile hits project is scheduled. It will show green with the on, and you can click on the on to get an overview of the schedule information. If you want to edit the schedule, you can click this open, and now you can open up the schedule editor directly here on the landing page without having to go somewhere else, which is really fantastic. So that's a great little feature that we've added here for the scheduled. There are other columns. If you want to customize which ones show up for you, you click on this little gear over here, and you can choose which of these show up on your project list. So there's a bunch of other options here, depending on what you find most applicable and important to you. Another thing that we've done with this table is that you can now customize the size of these columns. They previously were fixed, but now if you come up in the column header, you can drag this over and you can make it as big as you want. There are some mins on some of these, but you can expand or collapse your columns if you want to see all of your data. So if I have some really long project names, I can scoot this out. And now you'll see that this content kind of pushes off the screen. You can horizontal scroll to see it, or you can maybe reduce the size on some of the other ones that you don't need to read as long as some of those titles might be. So you have that option to resize those and see them. So a couple of other things to highlight is the searching. The searching is great. It searches across name, and it will also search across type and other kinds of content. So if I find like hit, in this case, it'll bring up the most relevant searches. So these are together to the top, but it also will do kind of this separate search. So I find H, I, and T in all separate instances, it'll bring all those together. Or if I search across mobile, see now I'm searching across name, I'm searching across tags. So I can do lots of different things to find exactly what I'm looking for. And the search will look across all of your content, whether it is inside a folder or not, from the folder level down. So if I'm on this root level, it will search across every single folder. If I'm within a folder, it will look at that folder on down. It won't search up in the hierarchy. So that's searching. We also have filtering capabilities. So if you want to filter certain things, if you only want to see like your mobile projects, or if you want to see a specific report suite, let's say, that's what I want to see. I can filter and sort these in, you know, whatever makes the most sense to me at this time. So lots of great options with filtering here. Anything that I apply here, if let's say I set this filter and let's say I sort by last opened, the settings on this table will be preserved. So let's say I open something up and I come back. So I go into a project and now I go back to the landing page. These settings are still applied. So this filtered report suite is still applied. I'm still sorting by last opened. And so it persists whatever your last settings were essentially on the table. So you can kind of customize this however you want to display exactly what you need. That way, next time you come back into Workspace, it'll show up in exactly the way that you prefer. So that is the table. Lots of great features and settings there. And that's most of the content I want to cover here on the projects tab. Next, we'll go to the reports. So as I mentioned, the reports tab is a combination of some workspace versions of our previous and most popular reports and analytics reports, like pages, page views, and so on. They're all organized by category, and you can scroll through these, and you can, just like we could before with the Miller column structure, filter down into exactly what you're looking for. You can also search across this to find something. So if you're looking for a specific project name, you can search and it will start bringing up that content. So lots of great out-of-the-box things that you can open up. So if I wanted to do pages, for example, I could click on pages. And now I have a workspace version of the pages report that previously existed in Analysis Workspace with even more functionality than what you could do in reports and analytics. Some other reports just to highlight. All of these reports have been updated. We just released combo charts not too long ago, and we've added combo charts to any of these overtime reports. So now you have combo charts out of the box attached to these tables with the same kind of data, just like you would see in reports and analytics. So that's a great thing that we have in here for these out of the box reports. You can click on the info icon to get some of the metadata. You can favorite here, you can open directly. Anytime you have something favorited, you have this favorites section that will show up. If you don't have anything favorited, then the favorites will not be there. But anything you do favorite will show up on this list. So you'll have these set of pre-canned report favorites that would show up here, not of any of your workspace projects, just your report favorites. And then, like I mentioned, this contains all of our previously called Adobe templates. Those are all basically the same as these type of reports. So we've combined them all together. So all of our pre-built reporting exists here within this menu. So these have a bunch of Adobe mobile templates. So these are all as they were before, but they're just now reorganized here to fit alongside the rest of our pre-canned content where they fit best. Two very important reports that I know everybody cares about that they frequently go back to reports and analytics for are bots and real time. So we have all the bots and real time stuff in here. So here are bots and the bot pages reports. Currently, these will take you to the same bot and bot pages reports as they exist in reports and analytics. We are working to bring bots directly into Workspace, but for the time being, it will pull up a reports and analytics version of that. You can also search for the real-time report. So if you click on that, this will give you our cleaner version of the real-time report because reports and analytics will be going away. Now you have just this full-screen real-time report just as it exists today with the little arrow to go back to the screen. So both bots and real-time reports are accessible directly from this reports tab. So that is the reports tab. Let's move to learning. The Learning tab is a great opportunity for newer users or people who want to just beef up their knowledge on Adobe Analytics and Analysis Workspace to go through some of this content that we've created. This is a collection of videos and tutorials to help you get up to speed on some of the fundamentals of Analysis Workspace. We're looking to add additional content in the future, but for now, this is more geared towards newer users and things like that. So we have a Getting Started tab, a Finding Insights, Understanding the Data, or you can just see all of them. And you'll see next to each of these tabs, it'll show you how much content you have completed. So when you look up something, for example, if I look at this report right now, these ones say viewed, this one does not. When I open up the video here, and if I close it, I go back, it'll now have the viewed tag on it. And now up at the top, this will say 5 out of 6. So this is a little counter. If you were to treat this kind of like a course, it'll show you how many items you've completed out of each of these sections. If for some reason you click on something on accident and didn't mean to, you can click on the viewed or the complete little checkbox and it will go away and your counter will update. And so you can remember to come back to that later. So we've got a bunch of embedded videos in here, like I was saying. You can sit here and watch them directly in the UI. And then if you want to learn more, there are links for each of these to send you to some documentation for even additional content if you're still struggling with something. Those are the videos. We have two tutorials. So if you click on the Workspace Fundamentals, this will open up a project in Analysis Workspace with some little boxes to guide you through some of the location and usage of different features for Workspace. The training tutorial template is the same one I was referencing on the hero banner, This will take you into a Workspace project with our training tutorial that has step-by-step instructions on how to use freeform tables and put together the content and do your analysis. And so we have both of those here up at the top is our tours and tutorials section, and then our videos down here. And we have a bunch more videos for different content down the road. So, and then if you've done all of this and you want to do even more, we have links out to our YouTube channel, which has a ton of more content that you can view, or our Experience League page that has a ton of content as well that you can find for Adobe Analytics. So lots of great content to help you get started and begin using Analysis Workspace right away. So that is learning. So a couple of other things I want to highlight. If you are a CJA customer, the experience is almost identical. The only major difference right now is that the reports tab does not exist yet. We do not have any pre-canned content as of yet, but that is something we're actively working on and we'll be having that soon. Otherwise, the rest of this experience is basically the same. So just wanted to call that out. That way any of our CJ customers who come in here and they might see this wondering if they've got a problem or not. It's just not there yet. So, and then lastly, just some general things again for people who are coming in and feeling maybe out of place, some navigational things. So up at the top, this is currently the Workspace landing page. This is where you'll most commonly start your experience when you log into analytics. But we have these other tabs across the top that are used for guiding you around the navigation. So if you wanted to look at some of your components and the component managers, so your segments, your calculated metrics, date ranges, and things like that, if you want to look at a list of those are all accessible here from this component manager. And then depending on what you're provisioned for under the tools menu, you might have access to a couple of other tools and capabilities, and those are all accessible from here. Any of our admins can open the admin menu to manage their report suites and any other tools that they might need. So this is an admin section only though. So many of you may not even see this. And then lastly, for any of you who is set up for labs is our testing environment. So we have prototypes that you can launch and play with and provide feedback on for things that we're considering adding to the product down the road. So that's all of these. And then over here on the top right, we have the report suite switcher. As you've been seeing me navigate around, you can use this to change whatever report suite you're on. If you have multiple solutions beyond analytics, this will take you to the solution home and you can change between any other products that you might own. And then if you need any help, we have places to ask questions, get feedback, look up documentation, customer care, all that kind of stuff. And then the little bell here, this is your little notification center. This will inform you of certain things that might be going on with your products and things like that, and then your little profile setting. So just some general navigational things here about the landing page. If you click on Adobe Analytics, it will always take you back to the Workspace page. It kind of serves as the home button. And as you open projects, if you haven't noticed, you have these little back arrows now that will navigate you back to this home page as well. So just a couple of navigational things for here on the home page. But this is the new home page experience for Adobe Analytics within Analysis Workspace. And I hope this has been helpful and appreciate everyone's time. Thank you.